Dear students, now we are going to discuss bipolar junction transistor and its working principle in detail. Let's start with the definition of BJT. It is a three-terminal semiconductor device. The three terminals are emitter, base and collector. It has two PN junctions in its structure. In this transistor, the current conduction is due to both the majority and minority carriers, hence it is called as bipolar. That means its operation depends on the interaction of both the majority and minority carriers, okay? Hence it is called as bipolar transistor. So next one, the symbol of transistor. So we can simply represent the transistor like this. There are two types of transistors available, NPN and PNP. So here we can consider NPN transistor. So in this one, this is the emitter, base and collector. The arrow on this emitter terminal represents the direction of current flow when this base emitter junction is forward biased. So here this arrow represents the current direction, okay? Then the structure is having three layers, N, P and N layers. So each layer is having its own properties. This emitter layer, that is N layer, is heavily doped. That means it is having more number of electrons. Doping means what? Adding impurities. So N layer means it is having large number of electrons as a majority carrier. P type means large number of holes, okay, as a majority carrier. So in this one, this emitter layer is heavily doped so that it can inject a large number of carriers, majority carriers, okay. So large number of majority carriers into this base. So the next layer is base layer. So it is lightly doped and very thin layer so that it can pass most of the injected carriers from this emitter to this collector. So it is very thin when compared with this N layers, okay. So the last one is collector terminal. So this layer is moderately doped so that it can collect all the injected carriers for its current conduction. Do you all understand this process? Okay. So this is the structure of transistor. It is given like this. So emitter is heavily doped so that it can inject a large number of charged carriers into the base. Base is lightly doped and very thin. Collector is moderately doped. So here the arrow on this emitter terminal is representing the direction of current flow. Okay. Next, the types of BJT. As I told you, based on the construction, there are two types of transistors available. One is NPN transistor, another one is PNP transistor. Let's compare these two transistors here. In NPN transistor, a thin layer of P-type silicon or germanium material is sandwiched between two layers of N-type materials. In PNP, a thin layer of N-type silicon or germanium material is sandwiched between two layers of P-type material. So this is the structure of NPN. Here it is PNP. In this NPN, electrons are the majority carriers, holes are the minority carriers. In PNP, holes are the majority carriers, electrons are the minority carriers. So the next one is very important difference between NPN and PNP. So in this symbol representation, the arrow mark on this emitter is towards the emitter terminal. Okay. But in this PNP, it is towards the junction. So here it is for NPN. This is the symbol of PNP. So this is very important difference between NPN and PNP. In real time applications, NPN transistor is widely used than this PNP. The reason is the mobility of electrons is higher than the mobility of holes. In this NPN, the majority carriers are electrons. So we can have the maximum mobility of electrons. Next, we are going to discuss the operation of transistor. In this, biasing is the very important concept in any electronic circuit. Biasing is the process of applying proper DC voltage to the transistor. Why do we give this external power supply to the transistor? In order to make it work at the desired Q point. So what is mean by Q point? It is the operating point where we can get the maximum output. Do you understand this one? So here we have to ensure that emitter base junction is forward bias, collector base junction is reverse bias. In this condition, we can get the proper Q point. Okay. This is the diagrammatic representation of transistor biasing in NPN transistor. In this emitter base junction, it is forward bias. Here this collector base junction is reverse biased. Forward biased means negative to negative, positive to positive. The terminals are connected like this. In this side, it is reverse biased. Reverse biased means here it is positive. So positive to negative, negative to positive. Okay, the terminals are reversed in reverse bias. Okay. So due to this forward bias, large number of majority carriers. Here majority carriers are electrons. Electrons means negative. Here it is negative. So same polarities repel each other. So this negative terminal forcefully repels all this majority carriers. That majority carriers are electrons here, right? So large number of majority carriers are injected into this base region because of this forward bias. So in this side, it is reverse biased. Reverse biased means here this plus is connected to this negative terminal. Correct. So here we can transfer more number of electrons from emitter to collector. Okay. So this is the direction of conventional current. Okay. So conventional current direction is simply opposite to the electron flow. Okay. That's why we can represent the direction towards this terminal. So here it is IE emitter current. Here it is base current. This is collector current. So that's what given here. Due to the forward bias on emitter base junction, a large number of electrons flow through the base into collector. So this produces emitter current. As the base is lightly doped with p-type impurity, only few electrons combine with the holes to produce base current. Okay. Due to the reverse bias on this collector base junction, most of the injected electrons from emitter cross over into the collector to produce a large number of collector current, which is nothing but the output current. Okay. According to Kirchhoff's current law, the sum of incoming currents is equal to the sum of outgoing currents. Hence, the emitter current is equal to the sum of base current and collector current. As the base current is far less than collector current, here the emitter current is approximately equal to the collector current. So here we know that the base region is lightly doped and thin. Hence, the base current is far less than the collector current. So here the output current is directly proportional to the input current, that is emitter current. If we want to control this output, we can simply control this input current. Since the output current is controlled by the input current, the BJT is called as current controlled device. There is one more current in this BJT, reverse saturation current or leakage current. Whenever the emitter side is open circuited, there is no input given at this point, base collector junction acts as a reverse biased diode. The current due to the minority carriers is called as leakage current or reverse saturation current. Okay. So next, applications of BJT. Bipolar junction transistors are widely used as an amplifier, rectifier, filter, oscillator, switch, etc. It is mainly used in audio amplification purpose, impedance matching, oscillator, filter concepts. Okay. Next, we are going to discuss the operation of PNP transistor. In this PNP transistor, the majority carriers are holes, minority carriers are electrons. So in this one, emitter base junction is forward biased, collector base junction is reverse biased. Forward biased means positive to positive, negative to negative. Reverse biased means negative to positive, positive to negative. Okay, the polarities are reversed. Okay. So due to this forward bias, the large number of holes are injected to this collector site through this base region. Okay, so it constitutes emitter current. Emitter current is due to the holes. Okay, hence the direction is given towards the junction. Okay, so next, this base region is lightly doped and very thin when compared with these two layers. So there is a small amount of current flow that constitutes this base current. And next one is the collector side. This is moderately doped and it is reverse biased. This negative terminal attracts the maximum number of holes from this collector. So there is a continuous current circulation. So it constitutes this collector current. You'll understand this concept. So here, due to the forward bias on emitter base junction, a large number of holes flow through the base into the collector region. It produces the emitter current. As the base is lightly doped with n-type impurity, only few holes combine with electrons to constitute the base current. It is very, very smaller one when compared with this collector current. So next, due to the reverse bias on this collector base junction, most of the holes cross over to the collector to produce the collector current. As I told you, according to Kirchhoff's current law, here the emitter current is equal to the sum of IB, that is the base current, and collector current. Here this base current is far less than collector current. Simply we can ignore it and we can say the output current is directly proportional to the input current. Okay.